first, I'll tell you what I get guessed at the most. I usually get guessed as Middle Eastern the most. And there's not much on here of that. But that is what I get guessed at the most. I was also a much darker child than I am an adult. And we were just talking about this the other day. Me and some friends were talking about how we've lost color as we've aged and how we used to be like dark children. And I said it was almost like watching yourself turn into a ghost while you're alive in front of your own eyes. It's a little sad. You know, one day you look in the mirror and you're like, this just doesn't look like me. And every summer you get a little of it back, but each winter you lose it, like fall you lose it sooner, and so you don't hold on to it as much. And one of my friends that watches the channel, she was saying that, yeah, you don't like produce the melanin. Like, we basically used it all up as kids when we like never went inside. And now we're in this melanin scarcity mode or something. So it is kind of something that you, if you've experienced it, it's a little bit of like a grief, because you feel like you look less healthy. You don't have the glow you had as a child when you were like, your shoulders were brown, your cheekbones were brown. Like, it is what it is. Okay, if I would have known as a kid, maybe I would have saved a little more as a friend in my adult life. But all right, so what I thought I was, and what, like, without doing any research, what I was told I was, like, my mom thought she was 100% Mexican, so I say that saying, like, she didn't really look into, what, you know, Europe came through Mexico, so she didn't really know, or think what kind of European could I be, and almost a lot of Mexico was mixed, you know, with Spain, and Portugal. So that was kind of, you know, if you really thought about it, we should have been looking at that, or should have been a little more curious about that, but we really weren't. And then my dad's side, was, his mom was what she thought was half Mexican, half Swedish, and then dad thought most, his dad was thought to be mostly Belgian. But there's almost none of that in mine. So either they were wrong, or I didn't get much of that. You know, you're not the same as your siblings. So like, my dad and his brother aren't the same genetic makeup. My dad and his sister aren't. Me and my siblings definitely aren't, because my siblings have a different father than me. But oddly enough, our charts are very similar. So come to find out, even though we have separate dads, we are pretty much the same. Similar, we're very similar genetic makeup, meaning my dad had a lot of the same European stuff as their dad. And their dad thought, and he's heavily Irish, so Irish last name, Irish culture, but thought they were 100% Irish. Like, nobody's 100% anything, you know. I'm a little linty from cleaning today, and I'm probably going to film a few videos, so this is my lint outfit. I did bring another outfit to change into for the grand reopening. Alright, so Natalie Rumler, my top on the chart is European at 64.9%. So if we weren't taking into account, if we were just going back to what we were generally told, what I was generally told as a child, I would have been, you know, all Mexican on one side and then a quarter Mexican on the other side. So I just grew up thinking I was mainly Mexican, and maybe a little bit of some mixed stuff from my dad's dad and half of his mom. But it turns out I got a lot of European. I got, so for the Northwestern European bracket, I got 38.7% Northwestern European. Now that breaks down further into Scandinavian, 11.9%, British Irish, 7%. And that changed, because the first time I looked at this, tire. So over the years, something happens to these turns and they remeasure everything. French and German, I got 6.4% finish, 0.7, so not much, but there's something on there. Broadly Northwestern European, I got 12.7%. All right, and I guess that means just general, broadly. Now, Southern European, Spanish and Portuguese, that is 20.9%, so that's a decent chunk. And I'm pretty sure a lot of Mexicans, like if you think you're just Mexican, if you take the test, you will find some Spanish or Portuguese. It's likely, it's not 100%, but it's very likely that there was some Spanish and Portuguese, you know, mixing. We won't get into that, because it was, well, never mind. Then we have broadly Southern European, so just a general broadly Southern, we have 1%. Then we have Ashkenazi Jewish, I hope I'm saying that wrong, Ashkenazi Jewish, 0.3%. So broadly European, just all of Europe, broadly is 4%. Okay, Indigenous American, 27.4%, so about a third. And that just says Indigenous American, it doesn't really say much about it. Oh wait, there's a little arrow, let's see. Explore your Indigenous American heritage, so I could do that. But let's move down to Sub-Saharan African. Okay, 3.4%, so not a lot, but there's, it breaks it down further. Southern Eastern African, 1.2%. And then Angolan and Congolese, 1%. And then for West Africa, we have 0.6%, and it breaks that down into Senegambian and Guinean, 0.2%. Ghana and Liberian and Sierra Leone, 0.2%. So broadly, Western African is 0.2%. African hunter-gatherer, 0.2%. Sub-Saharan African, 0.4%. All right, let's get into Asia. So for Northern Asia, it says, East Asian, I am 1.8% East Asian. For Northern Asian, 0.2%. Siberian, 0.2%. Japanese, 1%. Broadly, East Asian, 1.5%. So we can go into, it says trace ancestry, and there's only one like honing down in on my chart, and it will show you right here. This is Mexico. So it says that I have a whole bunch of, you know, Mexican cities, from Jalisco to Zacatecas to Chihuahua to Mexico City. I've been to Mexico City, Durango. There's 10, so that is all of them right there. So I've only been to one of those places, which was Mexico City. And I will tell you, Mexico City is so, it is so different. It is so fun to see. It does have a creepy vibe. And it's also like, I don't know if it still is, but it was the kidnap, that includes adults, kidnap capital of either the Americas or the world at one point. So knowing that, it kind of creeps you out anyways. But I was a teenager when I went, which probably even more teenagers than anything might be at risk there. So if you do travel there, just be safe, just like you would in a bigger city here. There's just things. Just be alert. Go enjoy all the cities, but be alert. You know, look up what you should do if you visit a city to be safe. And I was doing none of that as a teenager, which teenagers tend to do. So we can go into, I got a good story. So I was on here one day and I found the part where you can see who you're related to. And some of the names I knew, but some I didn't. So one of the names I clicked on and was just like, hi, you know, it says we're pretty close. closely related, but I didn't know you, so I just thought I'd say hi and see, you know, who you're related to me by. I think it said second cousin or something. And so he wrote me back. He's about my parents' age, and he had learned about his family recently too, and he was adopted. So my grandmother had many, many sisters. Many sisters. And one of the older ones had a few children that she had to give up for adoption for one reason or another. This was a long time ago, so she lovingly placed them with other families, and he, I don't think he learned about everything through this app, but he learned a lot more through this app. And before my grandma passed, he did get the chance to meet my grandma and my aunt and several other relatives that he didn't know. You know, he didn't know them growing up. He was adopted as an older infant, not newborn, but older infant. So that was pretty cool, and I'm still keep in touch with him. We're friends on social media. He's a really, like, awesome guy. He plays guitar. He's got a wife and kids, and they live in a beautiful part of the country. And just to see that is really heartwarming. Okay. Should we go with physical features? Let's go with physical features. Now, this is just a guess at all of these different types, like what I would look like physically. They try to guess. It would be interesting to see them put a picture up of what I might look like drawing on all those different things, you know? I spit in every video. It's hard to whisper a dog. Okay, cheek dimples. It says there's a 63% chance I do not have dimples and a 37% chance that I have dimples. Well, I do have dimples. They're not as pronounced as when I was a child, but they're there. So I got the 37%. I passed them down to my kids. Some people like dimples, some people don't. I think they're cute. So I'm cool with that. I'm glad my kids got them because I like to stick my finger in their dimples. Okay, cleft chin. 85% chance you do not have a cleft chin, and 15% chance do have a cleft chin. I don't have a cleft chin. I do have a flat spot, but it's not a cleft. I think it's another dimple. Okay, dandruff. Natalie, your genetics predict a 64% you have never had dandruff, and a 36% that you have had dandruff. I've had it. I've had, like, dry scalp. Like, I've had phases of my life where my scalp was drier than others. Yeah. Earlobe type. Natalie, your genetics predict that you are 79% chance to have detached earlobes. Is that a detached earlobe? And 21% chance to have an attached earlobe. Now, I think that an attached earlobe would be completely attached, and mine is, it has a lobe that's dangling. I got a dangler. Alright, earwax type. 93% chance you have a wet, sticky earwax. Yes, I would describe my earwax as more of the wet, sticky versus the 7% chance you have a dry, flaky earwax. What's better? I don't know. Eye color. 60% chance of dark brown eyes. You guys, my eyes, I always say this, it's easier to describe the color of my eyes as black than brown. It's barely brown. There would be a 60% chance of dark hazel eyes, 14% chance of light brown eyes, 8% chance of light hazel eyes, 2% chance of green eyes, less than 1% chance of blue eyes, and less than 1% chance of green blue. Now, it's weird to me that I would have a higher percent chance of green than blue, because my dad's grandpa had blue, and then there's no green eyes other than, now we have to go up more, so it would be my great grandfather on my mom's dad's side had those. They weren't just green, they were those sea green, like sea glass eyes. He had sea glass eyes. And my grandpa on my dad's side, he had those, like, mind chart, it says I would be less likely to have blue than green. Okay, and so when I say that my grandpa, so my mom's dad's dad, he had that sea glass, I do think that there's a part of Mexico that had a lot of that color, a lot more of that color, and I think it came from Europe, I believe. I would be interested in finding out where he was from and, you know, if that's a lot of the population there had that. Okay, finger length ratio. There's a 59% genetic chance that I have a ring finger longer than my index finger. I don't. I'm some kind of freak because I don't. All right. Freckles. 68%. I have few or none. 32%. I have a lot and I have few. Hair photo bleaching. Natalie, your genetics predict that you would 59%. You do not have photo hair bleaching. 41%. You have photo hair. Hair photo bleaching. So my hair does get reddish. It gets reddish in the summertime. Is that what they're talking about? Because I do have a little reddish. As I was a kid, it was a lot more. Even my daughter, who's darker than me, she's dark, and she used to get blood tips. All through here was orangey blood. So cute, because she had the curls. So I get a little lightening, and I usually try to darken it, because it's not me, so if I do get that coming through too much, I usually just put the black on over it. Alright, newborn hair. 55% of chance you had lots of hair at birth, and 45% chance, come on, all Mexican babies have hair, like almost all, and we have it like on us, and it falls off after a few months. Light or dark hair, so 67% chance of dark brown hair, 16% chance of black hair. I'm in between there. My hair is a little, well, let's see, the last time I dyed, okay, so all this, because the last time I dyed my hair was probably a little less than a year ago, so what are we saying? We'd be like right here, and you really can't see a difference between here and like in here, so I pretty, well, I guess I have black hair then, right? Hair texture, now this says 43% chance and slightly wavy hair, 28% chance of straight hair, 19% chance of wavy hair. So how is that? How is it that I have the highest percentage of slightly wavy? The next one is a large chance of straight, but then the next one is chance of wavy. How does that make any sense? But I have straight hair. I mean, I rarely see straighter hair than this, and it is really hard to style, but you can't damage it. You can't damage it. You can do whatever you want with it. You can buy shampoo at the dollar store. You can brush it, you know, right out of the shower. You can do what you want with it, but you can't style it. So that's that. And it won't stay up in a ponytail or something like that. Now, red hair, 99% chance I do not have red hair, and I don't. Although, like I said, in the summertime I get that red tip. Skin pigmentation, 35% chance light beige, 30% light brown. So I would say I was actually a solid medium brown child, and now we're at the light beige. Stretch marks. Now this says 75% chance of stretch marks, 25% chance do not estate. Like, good luck, good luck. I don't really worry too much about that. I have other stuff to worry about. But if you're still there, thank you for watching to the end. I also used a new mic today, so I don't know. It's going to be hard to judge because of the background noise in this video. So I'll continue to use it and try to get a read on it. My mom got it for me for my birthday. It was on my Amazon wish list, and I was geeked when I got it. So, and now there's a plane. Anyways, if you're still there, thank you for